working. Leaned into the telly. So been away for a while. In part literally, and in part just because Dark Souls seems to have hit a shelf level event. Not quite sure where I stand on that. I think it's kind of holding me back from playing other games, and the solution to that is to play other games. So here we are. And we are, what are we, 10 minutes until. 7 minutes until I can play No Man's Sky, which I have pre-ordered, but I thought I would have a look at this little trifle first, so I'm going to just dive in and probably be quiet-ish for a little while. Things start to unfold. That's an interesting choice. Oh, boy or girl? Well, I like being a girl. I'll be a girl. I'll be pink because pink's nice, not because pink is a girl thing.
Hello?
I did not know there was a character. Ooh, alright. Right, no, not that one. Oh, almost certainly that one. Does anyone actually enjoy pushing the stick and movement being in a different direction? Not quite sure what the difference is going to be with this one, but I'll just try it. Oh, I get it, I think. But still, that's just equally as weird, but in the other direction. So that's the one. Let's go. To lunch. Okay, didn't expect this setting. Fair enough. More for confounding expectations. Missing ducks. Open day entrance. Retrovision. Well, that's a C64. Look at that joypad. Just press some buttons. Nothing seems to be happening other than movement. That's fine. D-pad or left stick. Oh, balls up. Okay, Llamatron. Nice. Oh, what's that? Oh no! I've been tronned. Or similar. Okay. So, the premise being, what would isometric 3D adventures be like if we made them, if we carried on making them through to today? Well, here's what they'd look like. Don't think I can jump yet. The little shift in the perspective is L1, R1. All that's happening. Nice tactile kind of move. Oh right, yeah, so there's an arrow. I'm obviously going to go the other way first. Just to be contrary. That's clearly not going to work, but I'll try this. Okay, move. Can't jump yet, so. Rare goods on the box. Rare goods. That's very nice. ACG. Can't think what that stands for. I say a nice tactile sort of movement from room to room. Book of Lumo. I can jump a little. Oh, I didn't realise. Can't jump up there. That one. But not that one. Oh, I don't know if you can see that, but No Man's Sky is now playable, and I'll just stick with this a little bit longer. I like the idea of a small game and a big game setting themselves off against each other and dividing the attention and so on. A couple of years ago, Pixel Junk Shooter and Red Dead Redemption were the titles in question. Shooter kind of won out, but then I was very disappointed in some aspects of the sequel. Aspects which removed its free-flowing gameplay and restricted it to a grid. Well, there's a thought. It looks like I can't get back through that door, because there's like a spell on it now. Maybe I shouldn't be in here. Maybe I should be in here. To not be pushing in the direction. Just gotta jump some of those, couldn't I? Possibly not. I see a bit of verticality. What's that vanishing platform? Oh no, that's good. That's a nice. Nice isometric puzzle style. I'd wager that duck's going to need collecting at some point, given that that platform drops down to nearby. I guess we're going to get a net or a hook, maybe. Hook a duck. Classic British fairground game. Not yet, though. What have we got here? Green shape resembling a hat on top. If there's anything around there, we're not going to see it. Is that a button? Oh, no, come back. Okay, toggle, thank goodness. Right, so what can this do? Sparkly. I can see my house from here. No, no, I can't. Oh, big jumps. Okay, now we're talking. Floaty hat. Right, let's go. Let's go get that book. Perspective's a little awkward there. But... oh, no! Ah. That was poor. I'm happy with there being minimal consequence to that. So, as it said, exploring your own time at your leisure. Yeah, that works for me. Head over heels was mentioned there. The other isometric adventure that had the biggest impact was Cadaver by the esteemed Bitmap Brothers. It's fantastic art style, which in a lot of ways, maybe looked even better than this. Didn't have the 3D aspect to it, but literally 3D, this kind of 3D, it was fixed perspective. But as a game, I spent a lot of time playing with my mum. My mum has a fondness for adventure games, and that seemed to fit the bill. Alright, let's see what this is. Options, okay. Yep, so we've got to get ducks. Some intriguing shapes and so on. Cauldron. Cards, discs, cartridges. Cassettes and so on. Interesting. No other pages of the book, it seems. Book. Any time? Map. Can I look at a map? Let's just do that. Let's have a look at a map first. There we are. That's not very helpful. Still 14 pages. Should be fairly manageable. Beats, what was it, 18 quintillion planets in the next game that will be coming up shortly. Okay. Just check. I can save and quit anytime. Okay. Little more play then. Still need a key. Yeah, Cadaver was massively atmospheric. I mean, the Bitmap Brothers, you know, their art style is so distinctive. Oh, I can move this block, can't I? Hooray, a block-shifting game. Puzzle, that's fine. That's nice. Addressing this one. Now these look like they'll vanish. Yep. Will they be back when I go back in? Yep. That seems good form. Oh no! Was that a matter of timing? Jumping. Oh, it's sharp. I mean, literally sharp, and also quick. Do this a few times. Oh, there we go. It's jumping too late. Up level. Gone up more levels. No, perhaps not. Cassette! That's exciting. And that picture. Can't tell. Tell us anything about the cassettes? No. Let's get back to somewhere. Landmarky. Transfer the room. Thoroughness. Suspiciously empty looking long corridor. Do the rooms in the game need to fit together, or do they, you know, if someone drew a map, would rooms overlap? Excuse the sniffles, just a touch of allergies and so on. Anything anywhere memorable. Okay, that doesn't move. Can I take this between rooms? Head over heels had the bag item. Move items within a room. Similar to this. But not between rooms. That it seems is lifted wholesale. In a good way, that's fine. Wait, how did I end up here? It's a totally different area, isn't it? Okay, let's leave it there. So that's that for Lumo. I will end this video, check out, and commence exploring the universe of No Man's Sky presently.